Hey, this is Andre Gensburg, Mr. Writer, for another edition of ClayQuote.com's Bits and Pieces, and today I want to talk about do-it-yourself. We have become a do-it-yourself nation. This video is no different. It's a do-it-myself in my car. But we're a nation that really likes to do things ourselves. And here's the interesting thing. We really started becoming that way because we wanted to save money. If you do it yourself, you'll save money. I remember as a younger man, I would buy furniture that you had to assemble. Well, actually, that's generally the case for most furnitures now. But back then, they still had furniture which cost more, which was already done for you. But you could do it yourself and save a few bucks. There was even a trend where unfinished furniture could be obtained and you'd do it yourself, put it together, and sand, finish it, paint it, do whatever you wanted. Really, most of those do-it-yourself things turned out to be, for lack of a better word, crap. Things that would fall apart at the drop of a hat, screws that didn't tighten properly. And really, it was designed for people like me who wanted to save a few bucks and thought they were smart enough to do stuff. Now, over the years, I've tried many do-it-yourself things, and I've come at this stage in my life to a conclusion that I'm not good at a lot of those do-it-yourself stuff. Carpentry, construction. I'm amazed at the level of skill that goes into these jobs. And of course, for somebody to think they can just do it themselves because it looks easy, that's a foolish notion. I remember one time watching on television a painter who was doing oil painting and showing everybody how easy it really was. And this guy, in the course of about a 10-minute show, did this beautiful waterfront setting with pine trees, and it just looked absolutely fantastic. So I video recorded it, and I thought, you know what, I can do that. I'm a clever guy. So I went out and bought myself a canvas and some paints, and, you know, the guy was showing step by step, and I replayed the video. He made trees. It went like boop, 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 with just a little bit of oil, and it looked like a tree. I did boop, 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 boop. I had a blob. Didn't look like a tree at all. I followed this man's technique step by step, and the end result was his looked like a beautiful waterfront painting. Mine looked like a mess. Sadly, in addition, you're really not saving any money either, because as much as the notion of do-it-yourself is designed to fool you into thinking that you're going to save some bucks, what you're actually doing is saving the manufacturer some time in putting this thing together, and he's still recouping pretty much the same profit. But it got me thinking about several other do-it-yourself ideas that I thought, you know, we could throw out there as a little marketing gimmicky thing here. One is do-it-yourself funerals. Now imagine this, you can save a whole ton of money if you go and you actually dig the hole in the ground yourself. Think that one's gonna catch on? I don't know about that. About the only do-it-yourself project we all will agree on is making babies. That one we don't need instructions for, and we'll happily do it anytime, regardless the cost. Do-it-yourself is never easy. And things that look easy are more a skill of a person doing it, whether it's a painter, an artist, or a contractor building your house, than it is the fact that it really is easy. So I'm going to end this segment by inserting a little bit of a video that is a classical piece. It's a waltz called And the Waltz Goes On. And it's another do-it-yourself project because the composer was none other than Sir Anthony Hopkins. Silence of the Lambs. Woo! You never thought he would be able to produce this piece of music. Well, I hope you enjoyed that little piece of music. If you go to MrWriter.com, you'll be able to see a link that'll take you to the entire video. Otherwise, if you have something you want to say to me or a suggestion for a topic, please email me at MrWriter@ClayQuote.com. Otherwise, I'll see you next time, and try to be careful doing it yourself.